Hey, Metter UMC family. I wanted to provide you with an update on the ministries of our church and our plans for continued regathering. I want to first begin by bragging on you a little bit. These have been trying times, and we have been and are currently and will continue to live through uncharted waters. We're all trying to figure things out day by day. As the saying goes, we have been building the plane as we fly. And not just in the church, but in every area of our lives, we're having to learn new ways of doing things, new ways of doing our jobs, new ways of being together, and new ways of doing life. And with that said, I'm amazed at how you have stayed connected to each other during these times. Of course, many of you have stayed connected with our online services on Sundays. Almost from the very beginning of this virus, most of our small groups have been meeting either on Zoom at the beginning or now in person, socially distant. And several of you have told me that your group has been your lifeline, your saving grace during these last few months. That does this preacher's heart so good to hear. Our Sunday school classes have been meeting as well almost from the beginning. They all met on Zoom to start out, with our Sunshine class still using Zoom to meet today. Now, some of our adult classes are meeting in person at the church or on members' porches on Sunday afternoon. We've also offered online meetings and resources for our children and youth. And your generosity these past few months have been overwhelming. Not only have you continued to support the church with your tithes and offerings and continued to support the day-to-day ministry of the church, you have given over and beyond. You have helped families in need and loved on your neighbors. I am one proud pastor. And for those in our congregation who haven't been able to get out or don't have the technology to connect with us online, a weekly letter and a written copy of the sermon have been mailed to them. Suzanne in the office has done a great job of keeping our shut-ins connected to the life of our church, especially these last few months. Again, I wanted to begin by bragging on you. I know for many of you, you have really had to stretch your technological muscles in order to stay connected. So well done, and keep it up. I also mentioned all the different ways to connect to our church because I'm sure some of you feel disconnected. If you're like me, your emotions have gone up and down, not just depending on the day, but probably depending on the hour. And perhaps you feel alone or disconnected. Well, I want to encourage you to reach out. Find a way to plug in. We have several options. Listen, if Doris Cook and Larry Bowen can get on Zoom, so can you. But on that note, let me share with you our plans for us to stay connected and to continue regathering as a church. On August 5th, I'm going to begin an online Bible study on what the Bible says about uncertainty. Each Wednesday, a video will go out, and with that video, there will be questions for you to answer or for you to answer with your family or friends or perhaps your small group or Sunday school class. I hope you will join me in this study. On August 9th, we will again join together in Holy Communion. For those meeting in person on August 9th, Holy Communion will be a part of that service. For those of you joining us online that morning, you will go through the communion liturgy online, and then you're invited to drive up to the church and I will serve you from your car. If you would like to like for me to serve you in your home, I would be honored to do that. Just let me know and I'll make the time to do it. Then on August 16th, we will make the transition from worshiping in the fellowship hall to worshiping back in the sanctuary. In late June, we began offering in-person worship gatherings in the fellowship hall. These have been a great time of simply being able to see each other face to face and having time to pray together and to study God's word together. Now, I know this wasn't like a normal worship service, but what really has been normal lately? And even as we move to the sanctuary, everything won't be normal quite yet. We will still be sitting socially distant. We again highly encourage you to wear a mask. We're going to focus on prayer and the preaching of God's word. And while we won't be singing together as a congregation, we plan to provide some special music from our talented musicians and singers. We're going to ask that you enter the front of the sanctuary from the Lillian Street entrance. There we will have a hand sanitizer, limited number of masks, as well as offering plates for any offerings. The pews will be marked to show you where you can sit. And then after the service, we will ask that you exit out the two side doors by the altar area. As we make this transition, we will begin live streaming our services in the sanctuary. So if you aren't able to make it or you don't feel comfortable attending, don't worry, we're going to still be online. For those of you who are comfortable attending, I want to encourage you to do so. It is amazing the habits that can form in just 4 to 5 months. Some good, some not so good. So I want to encourage you to begin to retrain the spiritual habit of gathering together in worship. Again, if you're worried about your health, or certainly if you're sick, please stay home. Enjoy the service online. We will begin on August 16th by offering only the 11 a.m. service. As the need increases and if we still need to practice social distancing, we will then offer an early service as well. We're going to continue to ask you to register online with our quick and easy registration form. While we won't have nursery or children's church quite yet, we still have kids' activity packets for the children during the service, and this service will run roughly 40 minutes. The last thing I want to say is that it is our plan to continue our current course until at least Labor Day. While we are eager to return to Wednesday night activities for our children, youth, and adults, as well as providing nursery and so forth, we feel it is the wise thing to wait a little bit longer. With school beginning in under a week, we don't know the impact this is going to have on our community in regards to the spread of COVID-19. By waiting a few more weeks, we'll have more information to make a more informed decision. But let me be clear. As I have just bragged on you, church is still happening. Church has never been closed. The doors of our building may have been closed, but our church has never been closed because you are the church. And wherever you go, church is happening. Wherever you go, church is open for business. Wherever you go, remember to reach up, reach in, and reach out. Love God, love each other. I'm excited about the steps we're continuing to take to regather, but remember that wherever you are, God is with you, and God is working through you. As always, I love you, and God loves you.